Hi, I'm Andy Levine. I'm the program director for the Critical Care Medicine Fellowship Program at the University of Maryland. Thank you so much for your interest in our fellowship program. I think one of the greatest assets of our fellowship program is the multidisciplinary critical care training that our fellows receive. They train in the tertiary care medical intensive care unit, which provides them with training in lung transplant and liver transplant patients, as well as patients who are getting CAR T therapy, patients with acute respiratory distress syndrome, and patients with COVID-19, just to name a few. In addition, our fellows have experience in the community intensive care unit and also in the multidisciplinary subspecialty intensive care units throughout our hospital. Because of our partnership with R. Adams Cowley Shock Trauma Center, our fellows get experience in caring for trauma patients and also managing ECMO patients, as our program is one of the most robust and biggest ECMO programs in the country. Beyond the clinical training, I think our program offers a really nice educational training opportunity. Our fellows get educational training that starts from day one with a one-month boot camp that focuses on cardiopulmonary physiology and also delves deeply into understanding mechanical ventilation. But this education actually continues throughout the entire curriculum and includes critical care curriculum, core competencies, as well as journal club and grand rounds. Beyond this, our fellows are very actively engaged in research, and these projects really range from ultrasound utilization to medical education, to critical care research in the intensive care unit, to COVID-19 research. And because of their significant involvement in research, many of our fellows are very well published. And this makes them very well suited to pursue academic careers after graduation. Our fellows are also highly diverse. They come from a multitude of different training backgrounds, which includes medicine, emergency medicine, and combined programs. And this results in a very nice sharing of ideas and expertise between the fellows themselves. Overall, I think the University of Maryland is an excellent program that provides significant multidisciplinary training and produces very robust, well-trained, highly qualified critical care fellows. I'm very proud to be a part of this program, and I thank you so much for your interest in our fellowship program.
Hi, my name's Mohit. I'm one of the second year critical care fellows. I come from an internal medicine background, but I did nephrology before coming here. Coming from a non-pulmonary specialty, I feel that the program definitely gives us a lot of support in terms of procedural training. We have a very wide background in terms of our critical care training. Our medical ICU is very robust in the experience that we get here is pretty unparalleled to any other experience that I've had. And the non-medical experience is also very, very exceptional. We get to take care of a lot of sick patients at the multi-trauma unit and also get a pretty diverse exposure to ECMO, which is pretty unique here. I feel that even for applicants who are coming from an internal medicine background with a specific interest in critical care, this program will definitely give you all the required resources and training necessary to be a good intensivist.
I'm Vivian, and I'm one of the new critical care medicine fellows this year. When I was interviewing last year, I interviewed and applied pretty broadly to try to find a program that was the right fit for me. I'm from the Midwest, so I gave a lot of thought to whether especially a more distant program would have the things I was looking for because it'd be a significant move for me. I wanted a program that was multidisciplinary, where I'd be expected to learn in and be present in all kinds of different critical care environments, including various surgical and neuro ICUs. I wanted to be at a place where there was expertise in all of these areas, and there are also unique opportunities here, such as the CCRU. I also wanted to be in a program that had opportunities for development aside from excellent clinical training, and at such a big academic center, it seems like there is someone interested in doing anything that you might be interested in exploring. I appreciated the focus on fellow education as well. Now, having been through the summer education block, even virtually, I can say that it was a great learning experience, learning from these attendings in the clinical setting as well as in the winter education block. Finally, as someone who's EM trained, I appreciated that the program is experienced in fellows of all different types. I also like that the PCCM and CCM fellows have so much mixing and overlap, just because I think that it's a great opportunity to learn from each other and to support each other as well. All of these aspects of the program really stood out to me, and I remember that even though it's really hard to get a sense of the program's feel from an interview day, when I was here, everyone seemed really comfortable with each other and had a good collegial vibe, which I think is important in a work environment. So that, in addition to all of the other aspects of the program, convinced me to move out here and start my fellowship.